Greetings and salutations, everyone. My name is Samarno. Welcome back to part 12 of No Man's Sky. Last we left off, we had entered a system which was an Emerald system for multiplayer, you know, using the Space Anomaly, and we just were setting up a modicum of a base so we can find a spot to come to. This area is like extreme weather. I figured we'd make a base here. So this is kind of where we're at. It's alright. Nothing special. We're not quite to that level yet. We're gonna work on it though. So we got the base all semi-organized. It'll do.
Toxin protection.
For now. There's our space station thing. So what we're doing now, let's see if we can find it. Yeah, there it is. We're going that way. We're gonna build up our situation. Because we're not even gonna get out of our ship for this. So, out of space. Maybe. There's sulfur in here. There should be 5 sections. Sold. Yeah, just in case, I'll just move all these over right now. Ooh. You don't want to leave the system either, or like the planet, because then you get starships on your ass.
Toxicity detected.
sell our geodes, make up that space. Also, if you're doing a multiplayer mission, you can't teleport to a different zone because it'll say you're going to abandon your quest. So you don't want to ever do that. Wiring loom. What do they need a wiring loom for? I needed it for something. I think for my starship, right? Installed on this guy yet, but
units received.
And we're not even close to what we need for our cobalt. Turn it in. And now we're going to do this one. We don't need a walker brain, but yeah, I like to play missions with people I know, but I'm one of those kind of guys, I guess. Back to the same system.
big guy. So here we are back on the planet. In fact, I should probably give this place a name. It's dangerous out here, so. So let's see here. This is a toxic world, Gonesti Omega. Normally, I just kind of leave them with their names as they are, but sometimes I like to change it up a little bit. I also like to look at these. We're going to upload that. So, I'm going to call this... Hang on. I like to keep the original name on the title, too, so... Chemtrail. See, it's a joke on Chemtrail. See, it's clever. Yeah, right. Okay, whatever. Ooh, weirdos. Oh, okay. I don't know what that one thing that we killed was. It's gonna be a little more dangerous out here because we're gonna kill these guys outside. That outpost. Big. Big mama. Hello. 4 meters tall, damn. Alright, so we want to find the entrance. I like to look at these guys. I call these Gek dogs. I've called them that ever since the game came out. I think they're actually a cut enemy type, or not enemy type, creature type. I don't know if they're related to that thing I called the Grom, but just the other episode. They kind of seem similar in some aspects. Boy! Do that to me. I don't even know if we can actually shoot those. Oh, we can. Good. Because they suck. I can't do anything with that yet.
Weather warning. Incoming storm.
Great. Exactly what I need. Hey, is that a... It is an ancient ruin. Well, here's where we're at in terms of location, if you're interested. There, that's a decent enough screenshot, don't you think? Somebody. Yeah, not much we can do right now. We're gonna want those whispering eggs too. Though they sell for good money. At least this early on. Do that one, version 3. Yeah. I think this plant has activated Emerald, though. It does. So we would need a large refiner build in order to separate that into regular Emerald. I believe, otherwise it just tries to cover it. While we wait, we can just start naming a few things.
usually, again, I usually just let minerals be whatever they're named. I think that's our stalactite. Ever since the Suicide Squad, I've been referencing Starro, because he was always one of my favorite DC villains for how goofy he is. So I just pretend they're all Starros. First recorded on the corroded landscapes of planet Chemtrail. A higher order intelligence lives within its skull. The analysis process reveals an eidetic memory, though some brain functions appear resistant to the scanner. Sharp vision allows them to detect seeds just as they begin to swell in their pods, giving them an edge over other foraging creatures. Then they echolocate. I like that original rack. I don't actually know if I have to. Might be alright. Nope. Still dangerous. Alright. We could probably just do this as is. So this HeadGAD outpost. I like to help others and mention what's going on with it. It's an abandoned facility, so I guess I could probably just care of this and come back inside when I need to. Ship, stupid, come on, there we go. Oh, we're safe. Oh, we fucked that up pretty bad, but they can't get us in here. In fact, we may just have to cheat the system. What? That's not what I meant to do. Try something. moves too fast. That's not gonna work for me. So I'm gonna go try and find some health.
Toxic protection stabilizing.
Sometimes you can. Do this the hard way. Missed my shotgun. That was nice. Okay.
Toxic protection falling.
Is that we're gonna have to do it?
Toxic protection falling.
Unfortunately, we're kind of stuck in here.
store it, but...
Gremlin thrives on planet Chemtrial. Despite the constant acid rain, their lives seem spent in constant anxiety. They are tense and fearful, even on a genetic level. Comfortable amongst dense foliage, they sniff and scurry among fallen leaves, searching for the nuts that provide their food. Viking bond with cowards? Whatever the heck this thing is called. Encountered on planet Chemtrial, where they live despite highly toxic conditions, possessed of a tremendous natural strength, they fear no other creature that walks upon this world. Their finely tuned sense of smell draws them to the most beautiful, richly scented flowers, which they consume whole. Grow lungs after birth. That's odd. There's this guy. I call these things Koimilians. I had one that I called a Koimilian on a planet, Nottershenko. And I just kind of stem off what I originally call a creature, you know, I guess. Encountered on planet Chemtrial, where they navigate caustic ground and choking acid rain. Highly territorial, this predator continually marks their hunting grounds with scent. Pheromones are undetectable by herbivore species. Row after row of highly polished teeth allow them to tear through flesh and sinew alike. They can strip a corpse to the bone in minutes. Alluring pheromones. So, because they're similar to my Koimilians, which is a coyote chameleon, I had a couple of other ones, I think I'm going to name this thing after a piranha, because that stripping thing. So, these things are now known as... Piranodons. I know there's a Piranodon in something. I don't know what it is. It's an iguanodon and a piranha, in case you're wondering. First recorded on the boiling acid planet Chemtrial. Inexhaustible, their wings never stop flapping. Their flight around the planet is never-ending. Highly specialized sense organs allow them to dig through the fecal deposit of other creatures. Don't do that. That's gross. Sniffing out and consuming the nutrients within. With metal nests. Well, I did like you, but now you're grody. Like a poop back. Okay, encountered on planet Chemtrial, where they thrive in the chokingly toxic atmosphere. Steadfast, with a strong sense of place, they pick a roost and will not abandon their home unless facing certain death. Dense teeth and a series of extremely acidic stun masks allow them to consume a diet mostly consisting of rocks. 3 hearts. Let's see how we're doing out here. Alright. Nope. I was hoping so, because I guess you can still see them wave a little bit. They normally wave a lot. That's what I'm used to seeing. Where was this? There? No, it's a slate skull. I don't know what I call them. Thrives on planet Chemtrial, despite the constant acid rain. Brain scans are unable to capture the true essence of their simple happiness. They snuffle for food with their noses, I know it says noises, dug into the earth, flicking earth into their mouths with long, spiked tongues. Nutrient source is presumed to be soil-bound microorganisms, aware of its fate. Happiness, huh? Alright. Well, since they're apparently super happy, despite their fate, I think we're gonna go with the Carbonic Slate Skull. What's this guy? Oh yeah. Some sort of hog wolf.
see what we're dealing with.
Extreme toxicity detected.
Still storm, huh? Board over here.
Toxic protection. Falling.
Yeah, so is your mom. Alright. I'm gonna save. Normal? Doesn't sound like a storm to me. We might actually have to kill a lot more than 55 dudes. Usually there's multiple sites. Or if I say usually, it's like I've done this more than four times. The few times I've done this one, I've killed like three sites. Safety on? Oh, okay.
Stabilizing.
Get our safety on, we're gonna continue doing this. Should subside now. Okay.
Toxic protection stabilizing.
Oh yeah. My suit alerts me to anomalies in the network signatures, familiar traces of specialist Polo's meddling. The decrepit terminal, however, seems to have authorized the injection, detecting nothing amiss. Monstrosity containment protocol online. Indicate desired population control method. Audio repellent, olfactory repellent, toxic extermination. Sure. The system confirms my selection, releasing a cocktail of toxins into the surrounding terrain. For a moment, a spine-chilling wailing can be heard, then silence. Nice. Thank you. since it's right here. This was supposed to be a safe zone for this sort of thing. Ooh, oh, shit. Of course it kept going.
Extreme toxicity detected.
Women's excuse, restless sleep. The memories of a long-deceased tribe of Viking warriors flows from the stone marker, forming into a ghostly essence that fills me with wisdom. The Book of Herc speaks of the rise of the travelers. They shall ascend, delving into the boundless void. The Viking shall not impede their ascent, for the travelers must prevail. So decrees the word of Herc. After Viking increases. Word 4. Great. Okay, let's go back to base. I could have hit him for a second or so. I think the entrance is on the other side. I think I'd go around. Satan's a king. The song my mom played in utero when I was being, created, I guess. It's Satan's a spirit. So that's fine to me. 500, so. Let's see what we can get. Anything interesting. I was kind of interested in the stove, whatever you like to call those things. I think of an L, I haven't had any in my life. Mud Hut. This kind of seemed neat. What other quests do we actually have to do? Back to the first place we're in. Base is in another system. It wouldn't be any base. It's a base here. Find it. There it is. So I think I just gotta build a base computer for that, correct? Yeah. I could go to the other system, I suppose. Is it this one? To Itasco Colony? I don't know where the heck that is. Venom Sac or Sac Venom Base. Oh yeah, I forgot about that. And one other, I don't know what the hell that is. Probably the first base I had, I'd assume. So I guess we could go there, but Eh. Yeah, might as well. We don't need to build a second base computer. They're going to be worthless.
Wait.
Oh, really? Yeah, want to scan me? Alrighty. Oh, no. Shucks, where are you at? Shucks, are you dead? Cody, whatever. Oh yeah, here we go. Regular base computer like this guy. Automated archive recovery in progress. Data recovered 6%. New data available. Search construction database. Search archives. Construction database. Base technology data extracted. Downloading plans. Storage container plans restored. Perfect. Is that it? Nope. Additional data available. Log data from precursor recovered? Entry number 4925X follows. Found additional buried technology modules. Construction proceeding smoothly. Recent expedition yielded copying data to readable archive retrieval complete. Beginning defragmentation of next segment. Search storage container. Darn right we will. What do we need? It takes power too, I think. Yeah, five. 70 magnetized ferrite. I mean, 70 ferrite, but damn it, man. Really? Run low on ferrite dust. Now these will connect, you know, amongst various other. So like a zero storage container will connect to any other zero number storage container that you make. I'm just gonna set it right here. Need that. Larva core we can sell. Yeah. Do that real quick. With salvage data. Take all my money though. I'm gonna want these. We're gonna use that drop pod data. Probably not today, but we will eventually. That we need. I don't think so. Yeah. That's legit for right now. Oh yeah. Only name the saddlebug here. Forgot about those guys. This is our first planet, correct? Nataki. We had Chimono. Wasn't that? That was a frozen world. Yeah, it was the Avansask Nataki. Pretty sure. Ooh, that's really pretty. I'll have to come through here and name all these creatures. No. there's not really much else we can do right now. Start building other types of bases of wood. We'll get that grave first. So let us do it again. I remember losing that. Little guys are tiny. Alright. Crap. Ow. Lily Inso, iteration 237B MU4. Great signal to Korvax. I wanted to granted with convergence in exchange for the price extraction from my mind, their wrist recovered. I gained their lied to us. Convergence of bets. Sentinels provided with tribute. Carapace to Korvax helped them. Conceal. They are coming. Fire. Please step back. The fallen traveler's grave is marked by a glyph, an epitaph of some ancient technology. Extract glyph. I pinned the glyph, and with it the ability to travel to unknown worlds. I leave the fallen traveler in peace. Bird.
Toxic protection.
Yay. Mining beam?
Yeah.
Adios, mio. I love that. I saw a small bug.
Toxin protection. Falling. Light support power. None.
Alright, so here we are back at the base. I'm gonna heal up real quick before we take our leave. That's pretty much gonna do us for today. I will see you guys next time here on some more Nova Plays. We'll probably play more No Man's Sky, if we're kidding. I kind of been wanting to play a little Chilla's Art game, you know, it's been a while. I obviously still have to return to Resident Evil, I just haven't moved up to it. Like, just kind of like, you know, yeah, I'm sure you understand how that goes. But, really, until then, I will see you guys next time. I'll probably try naming these things while I'm away. That way you guys don't have to watch me try to figure that out. But until then, take care.